You're listening to Capital Extra. You've got Yinka with you, and I'm joined by Ray, who is one of my favourite people at the moment. I feel like I stalk you online.
Oh, I stalk you.
I'm constantly like tweeting you and putting pictures of you up, and I thought, oh my God, she's coming in. I hope she doesn't think that I'm going to see Yinka.
No. You're my girl, you know that.
How have you been?
Yeah, I've been very well, you know. I've been happy, working hard, writing, planning content, videos, just digging in, you know. Yeah,
I feel like it's been a flying start to like the year for you, definitely. Mm-hmm. Obviously, we're in March at the moment.
Yeah.
And yeah, I feel like you've sort of, like for me, you don't seem to rush. You're not like, oh, drop a video, drop a song, do this, do that. It feels quite organic.
It is. Well, that's exactly what it's like. It's like, oh, do you think we should put that song out? Yeah, let's do that. Okay, what about next? Yeah, great. Okay, cool. Like, it's very like relaxed,
yeah,
which I love.
I feel like you're the sort of person, or sort of artist, should I say, who you take songwriting quite seriously, because you were doing that for quite a bit before you became like a proper like singer.
Mm-hmm.
So how is it making the transition?
What, between like artist stuff and just
writing? And just songwriting?
I think if anything, I don't know. Sometimes it's easy, sometimes it's tough. It depends who I'm writing for, what I'm writing for. And when I'm writing for myself, I do overthink it like 1,000 times more.
Yeah.
But like writing for other people, it could be like, if it's like a dancey vibe that I just know is definitely not me, I'm like, yeah, great, this is you.
Yeah. It's easy, I guess, to take your mind out of it.
Yes. But then sometimes I'll be writing and I'm like, actually, I've got a really good idea in my head.
Maybe have you ever been like,
let me just babe, I've pocketed bare ideas, you mad?
You haven't.
I have. But that's just smart, that's being a businesswoman.
Yeah.
I'm like, the idea's a bit too good for you. Yeah. I'm a bit.
Yeah. No, if I was a songwriter, I'm telling you, what I would do is like, you know, like one for you, one for me.
Yes.
One for you, one for me. Because otherwise, you give everyone your best stuff.
100%.
And there's, I think, over the years of people being songwriters exclusively and then becoming artists,
mm-hmm.
there's always been a thing where they've never truly, like, there's
100%.
Been so many people, have you noticed? There's been so many people who've never
given away their artistry.
Yeah, and then they come out as an artist.
Someone else.
Mm-hmm. And you're like, oh, well, the song you wrote for J-Lo is so much better.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
Completely.
So I guess it does make a lot of sense.
That I got that with Katy Perry's songwriter. There was a lady who wrote all her songs, like Teenage Dream, like all these massive, massive songs. And then when she put out her own music, it was almost like she'd given
her songs
all
away.
Her artistry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But there's so many people like The Dream.
Yeah.
And also Christina Milian as well. She wrote a lot of J-Lo stuff early on.
She didn't.
Yeah. But now I've said it, you can hear it.
No way. You know that song,
that song, Play, Come and Play.
Yeah,
Christina Milian wrote that one. So then that sounds a lot like AM to PM, don't you reckon?
That's so interesting.
Mm. Yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to learn.
But it's good to learn from the people who have come before you.
100%.
And I don't feel like you've gone in the direction of giving away your best material. It's still yet to come, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
How do you pick like who you are going to feature with? Because a lot of your songs so far have had, you know, someone on the hook or mm-hmm. other people on verses with you. How do you work that out?
So that's actually all leading to a project that I've been working on.
Okay.
Which is like a collaborations project, which is coming out very soon. And
that's fun.
Hence, like, you know, the features that I've been working with so far, Mr. Easy, Steph, London, and Mabel, they're all kind of part of this movement of music that is just so organic and just vibes and just unthought, like, unoverthought, you know what I mean? Just like natural free flow and sick music. And that's kind of what I'm hoping this project is going to be.
And have you got all the songs down so far?
Yes.
So who else is on it?
I can't tell you yet.
What, not even like one person? And don't say you, because I know.
So I'm on it, Easy's on it.
Yeah.
Because the client's on
yes,
it.
Yes.
And Cigarette's part of it.
Yes.
I have done something with Kojo again.
Okay. So after check, you did something?
Yes.
Okay.
So that's
exciting.
But that's all I'm not going to give you.
It's all right. When can we expect it?
Very soon. We're just kind of, you know, figuring out, finishing artwork, getting some like little video content mm-hmm. things together, and hopefully within the next month or two.
Yeah. Is there anyone who has been on your list to sort of like work with who you haven't managed to get? Like, have you got like a bucket list of people that you want to check off.
So this project is kind of mainly like UK artists, yeah, and like obviously bar a couple of African artists that I personally just absolutely love.
Yeah.
And I wanted it to feel kind of like homegrown. Like everybody's done it for free. Like it's literally, yeah, like just
like
my
friends. Like a passion project.
Yeah, yeah, completely. So kind of the collaborations and the people I'm working with on that is very different to, you know,
like a traditional like studio album where it would,
yeah,
be, like,
I'm not trying
organized
to like search out the littest American and like pay him a, you know,
yeah,
it's just real and it feels like really raw and special, so I'm really excited for that.
So when you go to like studio with somebody, and mm-hmm, if it is like say for this forthcoming mm-hmm thing that you're going, yes, to drop, is it a case of vibes in, writing together, seeing how you like things, or do mm-hmm you have ideas of how you want things to sound and then you present it to them?
It's different. So some of them are like motifs or like little bits of music or just like a hook that I've started and I'm, yeah, like, do you want to build around this with me? I've collaborated with some producers, so it's just been like writing things together. It's just been like a really kind of different process. The trickiest thing about it all is actually getting the people to the studio. Because I will tell, yeah, you, there is such a thing as black time. There,
yeah,
is.
Yeah. No, it's true. Because
and musicians' time.
Yeah, yeah. Musical time in, yeah, is the worst ever. Like, you could be waiting for someone for 2 hours and they will convince you they're on their way and it's, you're sitting there.
It's a madness. No, I'm telling you, you could be sitting somewhere. Yeah, cool, I'm on my way. Stormzy's the worst of this. He's my boy. I love him, yeah, but he's the worst. Yo, Ray, yeah, yeah, I'll be there. I'll be there at 6. Yeah, great. This is like at 5:45. 4 hours later, I'm still at the same. I'm like, Storms, you can't keep doing this to me.
You've had dinner, you've slept, you've brushed,
right,
your teeth, and you're like,
you've
hello,
been home, played around in Mario Kart, and you're still not here.
I actually saw the video of you and your friend playing,
yes,
Mario Kart.
Yeah,
yeah,
I'm obsessed.
Why was she screaming like that?
Because she was losing.
Listen, lose gracefully. that is a mad thing.
She was stressed. This is the thing, though. It's very competitive.
I would beat you, though. Just so you know that. Okay. I would beat you. Because I'm like a savage when it comes to Mario Kart. Like,
yeah, but I don't,
Mario Kart,
I can't lose, and like, I will not lose peacefully.
Are you the one who would like turn off the computer if you're losing?
No, I will rematch you until I'm destroying you.
I have to retire a champion. The crowd is never... I would beat you. I would actually beat you.
Oh my God, we have to make this happen.
Yeah, and then
we
just come prepared to lose. Yeah,
you can't. All right, I see.
Pride is actually...
Very,
you know,
confident.
Very confident. Even Rob's, like, he's raising his eyebrows because I talk all this wreck and I'm probably not going to... But like, it sounds good, though.
Is she good?
We haven't played yet. We haven't played.
Oh.
We haven't played. I'll beat you as well.
Shh. The confidence, babe. All
right. I wanted to talk to you actually about, before we get into your mm-hmm new single and stuff, the whole reason that you're here.
Yeah.
About your style.
Okay.
Because you, for me, are like pure goals, yeah? Whenever I go on Instagram or Twitter and like, if there's an event or something, I think, oh my God, I love what you're wearing.
Babe.
So like, how do you...
But put it together.
Yeah, like how does this become this? How do you do this?
I don't know. I like bright colours, yeah, and like, I think I 3 years ago, I just did not care about what I wore and what I put on myself. And now I realised it's such an important reflection of who you are and expressing yourself. Same as music, you, yeah, know what I mean? I've just really fallen in love with it. I'm really into red right now.
Yeah. It's a good colour on you. It's a good colour.
Thank you. But yeah, right now it's just bright colours and cool textures, and I'm working with a really sick stylist now. I'm just, yeah, loving it. Yeah.
Do you ever get worried, yeah? Because like, do you ever have the like fear of having to outdo yourself when you go somewhere? So like, if you wear something sick to like the Brit Awards, the next event you go to, it's like, oh, I've got a... Does it ever make you...
Yeah. I think... But consistency is key. It's the same pressures with music, right?
Yeah.
If you put out a sick tune, like, Decline's done, like, really well. Now I'm like, okay, so the next, yeah, one has to do... Do you, yeah, know what I mean? It's just probably the same.
But did you have that when you dropped Cigarette? Did you have, like, the worry, the fear?
I think because Mabel and Steph being on that song made it something different and, yeah, really special. And I feel like females don't collaborate a lot in the UK.
Not
you don't
as
really
much
see
as,
that.
I feel like not as much as they should. Definitely.
Do you know what
not.
I mean? No.
Yeah. Because when you guys actually did drop it, I even said on air that it's something that I did not expect to happen, but I was kicking myself with not even thinking of it.
Right.
Because I thought, oh, I wonder who you're going to collab with next or who Mabel's
right.
going to... But I never thought of you guys
what
doing
about
it. But
actual,
it makes
yeah.
so much sense.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. So were people surprised? Because I was surprised in a good way.
Yeah, I think it's because we did it really randomly as well. We were like, let's just announce it and drop it all in one time, opposed to like 1 week to go, you know what I mean?
Yeah, and like, you
know, just like, let's just put it out and see what happens. And like, it's just had a, like, it got like 2 million Spotify in the first week.
Yeah,
I've never had stats like that. That's crazy.
But I think that part of it is, you know how I keep having this conversation this year, and it's that, you know, 2018 being like the year of the woman.
Yes.
And this is kind of like you guys solidifying that, and I think it's so nice because, you know, maybe less so now, but, you know, in previous years, it was like, you know, you or her.
Right.
It couldn't necessarily be room for three females on a song.
Right.
Like, even when they do, like, you know, like an all-star remix of a song, you get, like, one girl on the, or they do, like, a female remix as opposed to it just being the actual...
an actual expected thing.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And you're so right. I think the way I was made to feel when I came into the industry, and I remember because Mabel and I were on the same label.
Yeah.
And it was like... It was almost like, oh, you or her, like, one of you is going to make it and one of you isn't. And that is such a poisonous, like, mindset and mentality, you know? And I think we've just come leaps and bounds, just as females in general, like, the way girls are treating each other, like, at events and, like, everyone's actually friends, you know what I mean? And it's, like, really beautiful.
I think
really
it will surprise so many people to know that, you know, everyone does hang out and everyone does, like, like, even down to the tiniest, like, following each other on Instagram and, like, liking things and watching things.
Yeah, and supporting each other.
Yeah, I think it makes, like, such a difference to the music that does come out.
Yes.
And do you, obviously you have, like, loads of friends who are girls and stuff, but do you believe that, like, it is necessary to have women who do what you do, like, around you, supporting
100%,
you?
100%. And women with like-minded, like, I want to work hard and just, like, you know, this job, as you know, you have to kind of give it 110% and be going, and there's, like, struggles that you'll be facing that you can't necessarily just, like, be like, mum, this is a problem. You know what I mean? So I think it's so important to be around like-minded, hardworking, strong, sick female. There was a lot of adjectives.
Yeah, I was like, hit me again. So, cigarette. I have to admit, right? So, this is going to sound so stupid.
Okay.
Yeah, but, like, on your Instagram story and stuff, I kept thinking, why does she keep using the cigarette emoji? Yeah. And then... And then I was like, Yinka, it's because the song is good. And I felt very stupid.
Wow.
I know,
I
know.
Very clear.
No, but yeah, I think it's so obvious, yeah. I realised, you know, like, it got to a point where I thought, I'm that person, yeah, where you can put the time, the date, the venue, the price, like, you know, like instructions on how to get there. And I'll be like, when is it?
When is it? Like, in response to that exact message.
Like, you know, like the customer, it's like, this is £6, and then I'll be like, how much is this? I became that person watching your Instagram story.
Well, interesting.
Yeah. it was ridiculous, but yes, you got a song featuring Mabel and Steph London.
Yes.
How did it actually come about? Like, was it your idea?
Yes, I did this song like maybe a few months back, and I was in LA because I love, like, writing out there and stuff for, like, other artists. Mm-hmm. And I ended up being like, I want to keep this, but I need something. And I literally hit Mabel and Steph, and I was like, I've got this song.
Yeah.
I think we could make it, like, a proper, like, moment. And they were like, oh, yeah, love it. And then we literally all just got in the studio together and just vibes. Yeah.
And we were talking about the stats, 2 mil on Spotify in 1 week.
Yes.
Is it a surprise? Because obviously you are still, yes, relatively, like, a new artist. I feel like you're at the beginning of your career.
Yeah, definitely.
But you have become established quite quickly. Mm. So is it still a surprise, like, when you hit these little...
I think it's just, I don't know, sometimes things take longer than others, like, you know what I mean? But just to have that reaction, like, as quick as we did, was just really, really special.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I care so much, you know, so it's just, like, kind of that validation instantly, you know?
Yeah, no, I hear
you. And
it
had, like, crazy support. Like, it was on, like, New Music Friday in the US. Like, that's ridiculous.
That's insane. That's like, exciting.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
So I'm just, I'm really happy.
Well, I want to thank you for joining me on Capital Extra, Ray.
And we're going to, listen, Mario Kart is happening.
Oh, I thought you forgot about that.
You talked a big game now.
I tried to nice you with the stories after, thinking that you were going to forget.
No, you talked a big game.
But the thing is, I'll actually beat you, though. because your pride is at stake now. You want to come, you want to mess with me, it's
fine. I can't cuss on the radio.
No, you can't. Thing. That's why I'm doing it. Because the thing is, yeah, I work on the radio, right? Yeah. And I can find, like, inventive ways, yeah.
I'm literally like, she's like, this is no good. I'm being deadly serious. Yeah. We're going to film it as well.
Yeah.
I'm going to film that I cross you that losing. Finish line.
Your mate's going to be screaming for you in the back, I'm telling you. I'll watch. No!